Hey everybody, welcome back to Chronic Woodwork. I'm Andy. Today I'm going to show you how to build this college basketball wall decoration. Obviously, I'm a big Indiana Hoosiers fan. Can't wait for Hoosier hysteria in a couple weeks. But I had this idea in my head where it looked like I just took a piece of the floor of Assembly Hall and just pulled it straight out of the floor. So this can easily be adapted to your favorite college basketball team. Hang tight, I'm going to show you how I did it. To create the basketball court feel, I purchased a half inch sheet of the highest quality birch plywood I could from my big box store. I cut it into strips of varying size. I think some were 12 inch, some were 18, and some were 9. And then I ripped each of those into 2 inch strips. I used some blue painter's tape to minimize the tear out I had at the table saw, but when it was all said and done, I still had to do some sanding on all the edges. I laid all these pieces out on the ground and found the rough shape that I wanted to go with. I wanted this piece to look like I just pulled it up out of the court. Once I had the rough shape that I wanted, I moved some pieces around to create some seams between the boards. It's really hard to make something look random. When I was satisfied, I laid down my court logo and just made sure I had printed the appropriate size. Once the layout was complete, I laid down a scrap sheet of plywood just to protect the top of my table saw. I'm going to attach a thin sheet of plywood to help hold all these boards together and give it a little bit more rigidity when it's on the wall. So I laid the pieces out and put my piece of plywood on the backside, just etched the shape, that way I knew exactly where I needed to put glue down. I laid down some glue, but then realized I needed a means to squeeze the boards together. So I nailed some blocks to help provide some clamping pressure from side to side. I spread the glue out with my custom glue applicator and then realized I could probably use a little bit more. Finally, I laid down my backer plywood board and just found some heavy stuff to clamp it down. While the glue was drying, I went down to my basement and started laying out all my templates for the scroll saw. There's gonna be 3 total layers of my Indiana/IU logo. I taped these down to MDF and just took them over to my scroll saw and cut them out. If you have any interior cuts, make sure you do those first. Once they're all cut out, I'm just gonna stack these 3 together. My painting process is pretty simple. I hit all 3 pieces with some gray automotive primer, sanded them lightly, and then hit them with their color. I ended up giving each piece 3 layers of paint, and I made sure to sand lightly with some 300 grit sandpaper between each coat. While the paint was drying, I moved back to the basketball court. The glue had dried, so I brought it down to the basement and applied some Minwack wipe-on polyurethane. I really like the color it gives the court, kind of a more amber look, which is more realistic to me. The only really tricky part of this project was finding a way to hold all the wires and battery pack for the light system. To accomplish this, I just found a piece of scrap wood and cut a couple pieces that would fit behind the largest Indiana shape. It's going to form like a U shape. That way I can get my hand into this box and retrieve the battery pack if needed. I secured the box to my Indiana shape with some glue and brad nail, and then I just glued each of the Indiana pieces onto each other, just doing my best to make sure they were straight. Attaching the Indiana assembly to the basketball court was also a little bit tricky. I used some blue painter's tape to wrap around the back side of the basketball court. That way I could ensure I was driving brad nails in the correct location. It got a little awkward and I ended up on my back, nailing upwards into the Indiana assembly, but it got the job done. Okay, before I install the light set, I wanted to talk about it real quick. It came in a box like this. I'll make sure I post a link in the description below for the set that I bought, but it's super simple. It comes with a remote and it comes with a little C battery that comes with it. The light set, some adhesive, and this is really it. It's got 4 AA batteries that connect to a USB. This USB goes in, gotta get it the right way there. And then this set goes straight to the lights. And you're set up just like that. It's really that easy. So I highly recommend this. I mean, I don't know how it's gonna hold up over time or how long the batteries are gonna last, but I was super impressed with how simple it was. So let me get it installed and we'll get this thing up on the wall.
I removed the backing from the adhesive strip and wrapped it around our box. It went on really easy. Once the lights were attached, I finally got to see this thing lit up for the first time, and I was really happy with it. The last thing I did was move over to the router table and put a keyhole bit in the back of this thing and ensure this thing won't fall off the wall. I took it upstairs, removed one of our family photos, and hung it in a place of honor. Really happy with how it turned out. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Bye.